Listen, in talking to people, I find out that there are three descriptions of people's knowledge about God. It is shallow, it is inaccurate, and it is limited. None of those things will get you into the blessed place that God has laid out for you. Based on erroneous thinking, people are in certain conditions. But do you know, God never intended for his people to be in a condition. God has a position for his people. And until you know what that position is, many of you have settled for so much less. Many of you are walking around today feeling sad, bad, and mad. Many of you are blaming God. You are saying, God let me down, that God failed me. But I want you to know, God does not deal in down. Oh, come on now. God does not deal in failure. There is no failure in God, but it is only because of your shallow thinking, your inaccurate assessment, and your limited knowledge that you would dare believe that the Almighty God could be less than who he said that he is. Many people are living so beneath their privilege, and they are finding themselves going in and out of sin. So consequently, they don't have any confidence toward God when they pray. Their confidence has been shattered because you, in your shallow thought, think that God is only a God of judgment. But I want you to know that that is such a limited definition of who God is. God says, I've given up all of my very best so that my judgment based on your life will be victory and not defeat. God told me to tell you that it's time for you to recognize him. God say, first of all, I am love. Most people don't know what love is. But if you had an accurate assessment of who God is, you would be able to see the awesome mercy that he meets out to us every day. The Bible tells us in the book of Lamentation that his mercies are new every morning. Why are his mercies new? Because he knew that you were going to be sinning. And God is so good until God, one of his attributes is his mercy, because you are guilty, but God has found a way to deem you innocent. Oh, come on, give God the glory. It is because of God's awesome, incomprehensible love that God says, I give you mercy. Every time you blow it, my mercy is standing right there, ready to wrap my arms around you and tell you, listen, I have forgiveness available to you. I don't want to judge you guilty. I want to deem you innocent. And it's because of God's devotion. Do you know God is devoted to the human race? Oh, listen. Most people don't believe in God's devotion to the human race. So consequently, many of you are living your life expecting God to zap you. You're expecting God to put sickness and disease on you, to take away your kids, to take away your stuff, because somebody lied on God and said, the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh, and you were foolish enough to say, oh, that's what God is. God told me to tell you. I didn't say that. Some man said that. A man that was foolish enough to talk about me when he didn't know me. Listen. Listen. Anybody that talks about you and they don't know you, what they are saying is a lie. Oh, come on now. Listen. God told me that it's time for us to get this thing turned around. Listen, in the book of Proverbs 20:24, don't worry about going there. God said, man's goings are of the Lord. How can man understand his own way? There are so many of you sitting right here, and you are saying, I don't understand how I wound up in the place where I am. This isn't where I was going. This is not what I had planned for my life. But if you had gotten to know God, you would realize God is not worried about your plan. God is not concerned about your wants. First of all, many of you, if you could have, you would have picked an entirely different family. You wouldn't have come into the family. I wouldn't have been a Starks. I know that much, because I didn't like the way my daddy treated me. I would have picked a Jones or some, but thank God, God made me an Anderson, and I like being an Anderson. But listen, God told me to tell you, listen, man has been about the business of trying to be what he thinks that he ought to be. So many of you have gone to school and gotten your intellectual self all built up, and you have gotten all kinds of degrees and certificates on your wall. But you know what happened? It didn't make you who you supposed to be. You got in pride. Oh, most people that have all kinds of degrees and certificates are as proud as peacocks. That's how you know that I'm not going against education. Education is good, but it is not sufficient to make you who you are. That's why many of you, you have it, but you're not happy about it. Oh, but I tell you, if you ever get hooked up to the knowledge of God, that means that every other thing that you do, you will take it and place it within the leaves of God's tree. And when he gets through wrapping his arms around it, it'll take you to a victorious place. Many of you have wasted years